Sidney Simmons, Alejandro Wagner, Victor Blah, and Jake Bauer all on the undercard. Oh, look at that. We're going to be on the street now, guys.
Wow.
So that's your prelims, and your main card is going to feature a bunch of really awesome matches. You've got a four-man bracket with Lillian Tackett versus Aaron Harris on one side, Andrew Willoughby taking off here, Olivier Leclerc on the other, followed by Adam Bradley, not Kevin Bradley. And Nick Spacek, and then your co-main event is going to be the Austin Daffron versus Nate Williams match. And then we're going to get the finals of the four-man bracket and possibly a third-place match. We heard from the man himself, George. So, what are you thinking?
Well, undercard included based on fighters that I got the chance to talk to yesterday. All of these matches really excite me. Everyone here so far has been really game. If it's been on the card or in any of the tournaments that have been happening throughout the day. I think I'm most excited to see William Tackett. You know, I got the chance to talk to him a little bit. And yeah, he's my guy to watch. What about you?
Really interesting. I mean, all those guys in the four-man bracket are incredibly tough. I'm interested in seeing Andrew Wiltie and PO because it's just a stylistic difference. You know, Wiltie coming in from a little bit more IBJJF background and PO coming in from like a little bit more southern background. So, I mean, all those matches in the four-man tournament is going to be really fun to watch.
Speaking as someone that spent a lot of time with you and PO.
Brian.
Yeah,
it is. It's both of you guys as you were arriving, it's really obvious that PO is entering this with a level of confidence, you know, and everyone else just seems kind of subdued. So, but how do you think he implements his game?
I mean, honestly, the path to victory for both these guys is pretty obvious. You know, PO is going to want to try to get a little bit more of the leg walking game and some more of the Dan Hurd Death Squad back taking as well off of that. And, you know, Wiltie is going to be trying to do a little bit more of that traditional pedigo style, heavy top pressure. I mean, I remember from his match with John Holmes on Fight to Win that he's pretty dangerous anywhere, but he has really, really good top pressure. And the biggest thing in this match is the size difference, I think, because Wiltie cuts weight to make that 185, and, you know, Bio is coming up from 155 a couple of years ago, and now competing for 170.
Yeah, and it looked like from the time we spent with him, he had no trouble making weight. Everything was on point. He looks really natural right now and really ready to compete. Do you think that the current ongoing pandemic might have affected a few of these guys, not just in the travel that it took to get here, but, you know, in the training that they're doing?
Yeah, I mean, it's a really interesting point because, I mean, I'm down in Florida. Things are pretty wide open right now, but when you talk about parts of Canada, where PO's from, you know, it's a little bit more hard to train. Texas is wide open, so the Tackets have been training. I know Aaron Harris is in New York, and it's very difficult to train there.
Definitely, that's what I'm talking about. It was crazy to see, coming from Jersey, I expected myself to be like the furthest traveling guy for this by a certain margin. It was crazy to hear that there were guys from New York.
I know, it's crazy just thinking about how shut down they are, and I know how you guys are in Jersey with Governor Murphy and stuff like that, right? That asshole that DeBlas is always talking about.
Yeah, but, I'm not gonna make any sweeping political comments, but he is the governor of the state.
Obviously people are still training during this pandemic, but it's gonna be interesting to see. I know the medical guys have to slow down at all. I don't think there's a government that can hold them anyways, so. Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how, like you said, the guys who are in more restrictive states are going to be having
playing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to BJJ Woodstock! Seriously, thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. I know we are literally an hour late. I can't believe that you guys are still sitting here. I really appreciate your patience and your time and everything you've done today for this event. I put so much work into this, and I can't wait to show you guys tonight what we have planned for you. We have some of the best Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and submission grappling athletes in the Midwest, in the United States, etc. And tonight they're going to be showing out on our stage at BJJ Woodstock. We are live on YouTube right now. You guys can share the stream out. If you go to bjjwoodstock.com, there's the embedded YouTube video at the top of the website. Share that out to your friends. If there's people here that could, or people that couldn't make it here tonight to see the competitor that wanted to see PD, please share that stream out. We have an awesome crew here tonight. My man Mouse, Greg, Kevin Bradley is on the commentary. We got Star-Lord Ledoux down in Florida. We've just got an amazing event tonight, and I can't wait for you guys to see what we have planned. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get started with our first match. We actually have a bet match. This is not a match that we were planning on having in this tournament, but today there was a little bit of a mess up. I was supposed to put somebody in advanced E Absolute. I missed it. He went on to win the Blue Belt Absolute, and he's going to face the winner of our Purple Crown Black Belt E Absolute. So, first up, representing Citadel BJJ, Niraz Peterschmidt! Representing Wisconsin 360 Jiu-Jitsu, Mamu Jabbar! This is a special rules match. It will be under the IBJJF Blue Belt rules. This is a match that Matt, Layton, and Citadel BJJ put up $500 for. The winner of this match just came home $500 of that match. And let's go ahead and get started, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to BJJ Woodstock.
Stays on top, so that negates the points.
Good show of sportsmanship, even though money is on the line.
Looking at that knee cut again is Niraz.
Amazing guard retention, though.
Apparently, our audio is messing up. Mics are super low, so if we get the mics turned. Cut by Niraz.
Okay. That would be event runner Jordan Peitzman helping us out, running everything. Shout out to him.
Looks like there was a nut shot. Oh, no, it's in the face,
oh
not
boy.
The nuts.
Okay.
All right. Back into that home base position, trying to staple it, but Mahmoud's doing a good job off balance and looking for that outside hook guard again.
Oh boy. Really good inversion here. Able to retain the guard. Oh boy. It's a dog fight there.
All right, so in the close guard here, we got Niraz on top, Mahmoud on the bottom, looking for those sleeve grips.
Okay. Okay. With this one? Okay. All right, cool.
So we're working through some audio issues here. We're going to be trying a couple different ones. If you're in the comment section, just make sure you let us know how it sounds. We can monitor that and start working to fix it. Now we got Niraz back on top. 3 minutes and 38 seconds left in the match. 0-0. No advantages. No penalties.
You see Jabbar definitely looking to work off his back. You know, not making any effort. Just phenomenal. Oh, looks like Niraz's going to get back.
Justin Jameson. Better now.
Okay. Yeah, I'm getting text saying it's better as well.
Okay.
All right, so we're in like a single leg X. Oh no, the reaping call possibly.
No, it looks like it was not seen.
And there was an advantage, I believe.
Here we have Mahmoud really scrambling for the back to guard.
All right, so Mahmoud is on the bottom still. A couple near back take attempts.
Just amazing scrambles all around so far. Oh, looking for the sit-up sweep.
For some hook sweeps here as well, as he's trying to underhook the legs, standing to break the guard.
Oh,
is near off. So Kevin, how much do you train in the gi?
I do almost all my training in the gi.
Looking to come up, possible 2 points if we can establish. Now they're in a standing position.
Yep.
We got Niroff defending, Mahmoud looking for the takedown off the single leg.
He's trying to dig his head deeper into the thigh, into the hip. Oh, and an amazing counter trip.
All right, so we got 2:25 left on the clock. Niroff is up by 2. Looking at a knee cut, a modified knee cut here.
Oh, man, hockey fight.
Yeah, love me some hockey fights.
All right.
They clear the gi.
Very quick on that.
I like that ambient music in the background. Very calming.
Yeah.
Again, this match is under IBJJF rules. They got a minute and 35 seconds left. Niroff is up by 2 in the white gi. Crowd erupts when they find out there's shekels on the line. Grabs his pants. Great, great advice from the crowd. Oh, potential sweep attempt there. Into a bolo, maybe?
Keep the pants on.
I almost saw his cheek.
That is a lot.
All right, and ooh, coming up, he's gonna get 2 there.
Josh, you ever lose your pants mid-roll?
All right, so now we got Mahmoud up by 2 advantages here. Score tied 2-2.
Now it's interesting seeing him try to pass here at the end.
Ooh, possible pass. Good turtle.
Very good.
Oh, moving into the back tick, right into the screens. That's what I was worried about.
Off the screens. Yeah, right away. You're touching
them.
Off the screens, away from the screens.
We heard about how hard it was to get these screens. So,
and one might have been lost in the line of duty.
Yeah, by an astray drone.
Yeah. They're a menace.
Yeah. Good reset by the referee. Same position. We're going to have possible points here. There's the 4. With 10 seconds left, looks all like right. Mahmoud is going to come through and win on points.
Definitely start.
And there's 4 for Mahmoud. Time!
Wow.
All right, $500 winner for Mahmoud.
He's definitely excited about it.
Yeah, he's very excited.
I mean, who wouldn't be? Very few people are above $500.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of the opening fight of BJJ Woodstock and the winner of $500 presented by Citadel BJJ and Matt Layton, Mahmoud Jabbar!
You know, for a pajama fight, that was pretty entertaining.
Honestly, a lot of great transitions, great scrambles. Both guys were really hunting for it the entire time.
All right, so I think we're moving now into the prelims. All right, so I'm going to pull up our first match of the night. If I'm not mistaken here,
This will be Mr. Steve Merrill versus Timmy Carpenter.
Shout out to Michelle for all of her work on that match today. We had a handful of injuries at the open tournament, so give it up for your medic.
Definitely.
Giving it up for the medic.
It's an amazing event from dawn to dusk here at BJJ Woodstock. Now, first event should be Steve Merrill versus Timmy Carpenter. I have not had the pleasure of meeting Timmy. I did meet Steve the other day. He seemed very excited. I got the chance to talk to him. You could, might have caught it on the Jiu-Jitsu Times Instagram stream, but he said he's looking to wrestle. He's looking to be a lot of physical pressure to bring in the...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get started with our next match. Next up, we have a purple belt feature match at 145 pounds. First up, representing Fight for Lake Martial Arts in Fort Dodge, Iowa, Steven Merrill.
That would be Steve. There he is. Complete.
I like the stash.
Yeah, he's very proud of it.
And next up on the right-hand side, we have representing Academy of Combat Arts in Fargo, North Dakota, Timmy Carpenter!
All right. Oh, that is Mr. Carpenter.
The baby face with the cartoon spats and rash guards. I love it.
Could be. It's anyone's guess. You know?
Who would have known?
Yes.
Now, I'm going to have to ask Jordan, what is the rule set for the undercard matches?
So for the undercard matches...
Oh, right into the inside heel hook!
Wow. Looks like Timmy Carpenter is on an inside heel hook here.
He's
right away, about 10 seconds into the match.
He might not get that. You need to be on the wrist bone a little bit more, and he's ripping across his body with an open circuit. But then again, it's purple belts. Good stack here.
But again, as he escapes that leg lock, the rules here for our prelim matches are going to be 6-minute submission-only regulation with a 3-minute scored overtime if need be. Our title matches tonight, our men's 185-pound championship will utilize a 10-minute submission-only regulation followed by a 3-minute overtime scored if need be.
Got it. That makes a lot of sense. And right away, we got Tim back on the footlock attempt, going for a straight ankle, and Steve doing a good job stacking out of it.
He did say he was going to be employing a lot more wrestling in this match, and it looks like he's holding to that so far.
Who said they were going to wrestle?
Merrill.
Okay. Very calm, still addressing, trying to fight the head. Now he's in a smash pass position.
Looks like he's moving successfully up. I don't know what if his other leg is free right now.
Now, again, there's no points in the regulation, so, you know, nothing to be awarded here other than the dominant position.
All right, looks like Steve's moved to side control. Oh, wow, amazing flexibility on display.
Inverting through, Steve dropping back for a leg of his own. Doesn't have an entanglement yet. Still looking for that inside heel hook, though.
Gotten a bit of that. Just a
good re-pummel.
Full leg attacks.
Nice re-pummel by Tim. Looking for an inside heel hook. Switching to the outside now. He's going standard Ashi. And he gets the outside heel hook win.
Amazing job. Amazing.
Outside heel hook.
Very nice.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Timmy Carpenter.
Phenomenally brisk pace to start off the non-betting prelims. Incredible so far.
All right, we're getting ready to move it here to the next match.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll move into our next match. This one is a purple belt feature match at 145 pounds. First up, representing Carlson Gracie team, Sean Richmond.
All right, Sean Richmond, Carlson Gracie. Oh, I've seen this guy around today. Did they say what belts these guys were?
And next up, representing Kearney Sports Center, Alex Weaver!
I like Alex Weaver. He said very nice things about me today.
Oh, really?
Nobody says nice things about you, though, Kevin.
I mean, why would they?
Yeah, I don't know. Because they love you?
Impossible, Josh. But do you think that?
So we got Alex on the right here. Bigger, stronger guy. And then we got Sean in the purple belt rash guard. Alex jumps the guillotine.
Right into the guillotine. That looked tight for a second.
Alex looks like a wrestler.
Oh, yeah.
Nice overhook control here. Nice flying scissor attack.
Very smooth.
Right in on the legs is Alex.
That was one of the moves you were hoping to see. You said that right before we started.
As long as we don't see a decapitator, I'm happy.
Ooh.
Or they got so many names for that that submission now. Dragon Sleeper. Executioner. All right, so we got Alex on top in a knee cut position.
Ooh, going in on the leg. Looks like a straight ankle lock.
Yeah, he's got to pinch that elbow a little bit more. Yep. He's two up on that elbow.
Also just like the one-hand grip, a little bit tougher and nuggy.
Sean doing a good job trying to separate the legs. Alex switches it to an inside heel hook attempt, but he's not got a full triangle yet. Now he's looking more of a 50-50 attack.
Sit down. Another lightning quick.
I didn't really catch what that submission was, but it was a leg lock.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by way of submission, Alex Weaver!
Phenomenal job. Wow.
Yeah, there it is, Alex Weaver finishing with a leg lock. I like all the anti-flow comments we're getting on the stream. Jordan, you're doing a great job. They love the fuck flow shirt. Yeah, it's because of this right here. Exactly.
Oh, wait. Are we on that game?
Right here. There you guys go.
Oh,
boom.
Boy.
Yeah.
I cannot endorse nor acknowledge any of the messages of the apparel that my co-host is currently wearing.
Listen, sometimes you got to do what you got to do, all right? So we got one more or another match coming up here. Stephen Gladhill against Matt Marchese. Matt is from Black Hole Jiu-Jitsu in New York.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's move into our next matchup of the night. This one is a purple belt feature match at 155 pounds. First up, representing Stock Valley Jiu-Jitsu and Carlson Gracie team, Stephen Gladhill. And next up, visiting us from Black Hole Jiu-Jitsu in upstate New York, Matt Marchese.
I'm going to call him Marchese.
Bold fashion statement with the one sleeve rash guard.
Where is his other sleeve?
No one knows, Josh.
All right, so Matt with the one sleeve, and then Steven in the black rash guards here.
Not much sleeve, though.
Matt pulls guard. A little bit of a Burt Reynolds position here.
We saw him practicing the scissor sweep earlier.
You mean scissor leg takedown? Yes, he was. I'm sorry, my co-host is a blue belt.
I am what I make up for in lack of experience. I make up for in charm. That's what I'm going with. Going hard on the leg.
All right, moving into 50-50, triangling his legs here. Looking to get his grip. Hand fighting real well. Ooh, he almost had that grip, but again, too high. There it is. Matt Marchese with the inside heel hook.
There's nothing but speed.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by submission.
He looks like a demon.
Inside heel hook, Matt Marchese.
And he just ripped off his sleeve. I like it.
Oh, wow.
He's just like, take that sleeve, goodbye.
Just an incredible night thus far. Nothing but heat on the prelims.
Yeah, nothing but heat, man. All these guys are bringing it. They're looking for the subs real fast. I mean, obviously, these no-gi matches are very fast-paced. The gi match was looking pretty good as well. But, yeah, man, lots of leg locks in the beginning.
Are you surprised? Just because typically that's how sub-only events tend to go.
I'm not surprised, motherfuckers.
All right, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have a purple belt feature match at 135 pounds. First up, representing Hard Drive MMA, Jonah Nassib.
All right, so Mr. Jonah in the blue. Wow, people like Jonah in the blue belt rash guard.
And next up, representing Iowa Martial Arts and Wellness, by way of Des Moines, Iowa, give it up for the hometown competitor, Colby Heller.
And Colby Heller over here.
A
Lots of love for both these guys.
Lots of love for Jordan's excellent announcer voice.
Yeah, obviously. All right, so we got Jonah on the left, Colby on the right. Jonah's in the blue belt, ranked rash guard.
Media going for the snap from both of them.
A little more wrestling. I kind of like it. Yeah. Good head position here, an inside tie by Jonah. Guard pull immediately by Colby. Jonah's like, nah, dude, we're wrestling.
Yeah.
Let me take you down. I don't want to see you pull guard. Right away, pulls guard again. Jonah doesn't really like that. He wants to earn his top position, it seems.
Definitely looks more comfortable playing on the feet.
Faking the level change here. Right away wins that head position every time. Now we're back to neutral. Looking for a duck under. And Colby's like, all right, let's get this to the ground. Nice little Tominagi attempt on the neck.
Oh, that was a beautiful transition.
That was very nice.
That is the like basic idea of the butterfly sweep. I feel like that was...
I'm really glad the camera's not on me because I just rolled my eyes so hard at you.
I deserved it.
Anyways, we got Jonah again with the underhooks now. Possible knee tap coming here. Rick James foot sweep attempt.
Now they are getting a little close to the edge for my liking.
Some of us like to live on the edge.
Yeah, I don't want this wrestler to blast him through the table, though.
Inside. Recounter, looking for his legs, back on the edge of the mat, looking for the duck under. Wow. Shit. That would have been scary.
That was, yeah.
Trying to keep the cursing to a minimum, but it was scary.
It was very, very frightening.
Oh, great level change again by Jonah. Colby comfortable pulling guard. Always getting that head control. Controlling the wrists.
Are you a wrestler or are you a little bit of a guard puller, Kev?
I am a complete guard puller, which sucks because my dad was
looking for that shoulder lock. No. John Jones shoulder lock here. Thanks, man. We do sound good. I'm kind of professional today.
And I feel like I'm professional by the elevation I get from being next to you, Josh.
Oh, there you go.
Josh, this is like got nothing to do with anything, but you're terrible at Smash.
We can address this later. We got matches to talk about. So we got a little bit more than 3 minutes left in the match between Jonah and Colby. Some trends we've been seeing is Colby does not mind being on the bottom. Jonah really wants to dictate when he takes this to the mat and where. Not really trying to engage too much in the guard game.
Yeah, he's been faking the level changes a lot.
Now, this does go to a 3-minute overtime with points, if necessary. I think that's where Jonah's going to shine a little bit more. Colby's shown more submission savviness so far this match. And Jonah's a little bit more positionally dominant. Was my insight just too good? You didn't really have anything to say?
I feel like you just closed the book on it. You left me feeling very well informed on the issues.
I hope someone got a picture of that because it looked like that Finger of God painting right there. So I want to see if someone got a picture of that so I can blow it up and put it in my dojo.
Phenomenal. How many pictures of yourself do you have in your dojo?
None. And stop calling it a dojo. I accidentally did because Mouse was saying it all day and it stuck in my head. All right, we're back to the match. Looking at guard pass here. Hand control here.
Looks like Colby's looking to better establish his half guard. Oh, almost a crucifix. Colby back to playing guard. Jonah just really sticking on top.
Looking for an omoplata attempt.
Although, now Jonah trying to stack, possibly losing control of his arm. And we're back to Colby playing guard, inverting. Oh, maybe possibly locking up.
That was almost back take there.
Oh, wow.
Good explosion by Mr. Jonah now to be a cross side with a minute and 10 left on the clock.
Looks like Jonah might be trying to transition to mount. Colby does have that hook in. Now that Jonah's in that finally past the guard, he's really not wanting to do that up. He's fighting hard. Oh.
Ooh, looking to mount.
I mean, he's so positionally sound, it's almost like he's getting ready for the overtime. Oh. 15 seconds left on the clock.
Time! All right, ladies and gentlemen, now we will move to our first overtime of the night. This will be a 3-minute round where the points will be scored.
All right, so now we have like a second.
Do you think Kobe changes his game up?
I don't know, man. I would definitely pull guard sooner if I was him because Jonas seemed to be pretty strong with the takedowns. Great observation from the crowd saying he's going to try to wrestle you.
We need to get that guy up here.
Yeah, we need his insights. I got a sense that this crowd's going to eventually turn into the Just Bleed crowd, and I'm looking forward to it.
Phenomenal. I feel like that guy's a spirit. He shows up whenever it's time to Just Bleed.
Ooh, nice shot. Oh,
man,
Colby with the takedown.
Obvious immediate change up from how he played in regulation.
Count me surprised, man. I did not think. Ooh, he's tight in on that neck. That does not look like it's a good angle.
And a great sweep by Jonah.
Two there. So now we're tied 2-2.
Jonah looks to be closer to passing the guard, getting that knee through. And
ooh, nice knee cut. But right away, we got a turtle attempt.
Trying to turn up.
There it is. He should be getting the points. And there's three. And he right away goes to mount.
Jonah
Nessa
takes
a 5-2 lead here with a 40 left over.
There should be more points there for the mount, I believe, but we shall see. Oh, nice hip escape right away.
Again, getting closer to the edge. It'll be interesting to see if they get reset. And
I love
there it.
It
is.
It's exhilarating. I'm getting ready to start trolling people for fun. Nah, I'm going to keep this professional for now.
Mean comments.
Oh, I love the mean comments. They give me fucking energy.
They like mean tweets. Sorry about that, folks.
All right, so we got a 5-2 lead for Jonah with 1 minute left.
Colby was really quick with that shot. Be interesting to see if he goes for it again. Another reset. He's getting a little heated on the mats.
He's just talking a little trash like I like to do. Come on, man.
Ooh,
nice
another great shot. Driving him out.
We're going to get on the back.
Does he get the hooks in? Does he get the hooks in?
No hooks yet.
Still riding out the clock. Almost
using
10 seconds
half
left.
Nelson on top. There's two for the takedown. There's a little bit of a reversal.
Oh, is he going to get
the? He's in the teepee.
Time!
That was an entertaining match.
Great way to end the fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, 5-2. in overtime, Jonah Nassif.
Jonah Nassif, 5-2 win overtime.
Just put both game guys. And what an electrifying first overtime match in the prelims.
Yeah, that was entertaining for sure. All right, now we are awaiting our next match. Do you have the brackets?
Sorry, I was just taking a look at some of the nice comments that people have been leaving on the.
You mean my one favorite troll?
Your army is impeccable. All right, here's our prelim quest once again.
All right, so next we have.
Wait,
Tanner Fletcher and Carlos Garcia.
Oh, no, you guys are good. Yeah, you guys are good. Sorry, I'm talking to myself.
Oh, I am right.
You're always right.
Thanks, bud. How does it feel to be right so often?
I don't know. Ask my wife.
Okay. Phenomenal. Shout out Mrs. Star-Lord or Gamora.
There you go.
Is that how that works?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's pretty much. So here we are in... Iowa.
Yeah. How's it been treating you so far, Josh?
It's my first time.
First time?
Yeah.
Me too. Honestly.
I don't know
not
how much to say other than it's been Iowa. You know?
It has been Iowa.
Yeah.
You know, and we've been here. We've had fun here. We've laughed here. We've cried here. It's been an amazing, amazing venue. It changed my life, being in Iowa.
Cool.
Although you guys do need a little bit more on the Uber department. Like more
Ubers. Yeah, Iowa, fix your Ubers so I'm not driving people around.
Yeah, I'm not trying to complain. I know I'm very lucky to come. Like, oh. Okay.
Wait.
He murdered an Uber.
Oh, okay, great.
And just like that, then took his car. The lack of Ubers is now making more sense in the area, so I suppose I would just like to say, Uber drivers, be careful if Tex Johnson is in town. Maybe turn off the meter for the night.
I'm not going to say anything. He's a very nice man.
He's a very nice man, sure.
He will just tear you limb from limb.
Hey, Uber's the first natural predator,
all right? All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get started with our next
moving into the next match.
Purple belt feature match.
Carlos Garcia.
This is
Tanner
first
Fletcher.
First up, representing Pinnacle Beach and Jack, Tanner Fletcher.
There we go.
All right, Tanner out in the purple.
Very sharp cut.
Space
and
shorts.
Pony, representing Real Warrior Academy. Carlos Garcia
in the spats with no shorts.
Very 90s Miami style rash guard. It looks like very, very.
Some people have rules against just spats, you know, and I appreciate those people.
Yeah, not a fan.
No, Kev, I'm not.
I've met too many people who are all about just spats.
Carlo pulls guard immediately, looking for the arm drag.
Tanner looking to pass. Trying to maybe get to mission control.
All right, so still in the half guard here, looking for almost like a deep half sweep into Ashi. Gary Tonin does this entry a lot. Looking for the straight ankle lock. He's on that Brazilian part of the bone, so, I mean, I don't know if he does have it. The angle does not look great.
Doesn't seem like he can extend much.
Yeah, and he doesn't really have tight elbow positioning. He's looking to regrip now. Tanner starts stacking.
Remain very calm in the middle of the leg lock. Trying to control the head of Carlos Garcia. Well, maybe going in for a Darce.
Pretty sure Hal Teague's in the comments here,
oh,
and I
boy.
Love it
again. Not gonna.
And
not gonna
now
touch
we're
one.
Straight into mount.
Oh, wow.
Looking back into half guard. Nice escape there by Carlos. Looking for like a modified lockdown here.
Looking for the underhooks as well.
Half guard really is a battle of underhooks. Looking for the Kimura now is Carlos. Tough to hit from bottom half.
Yeah, it's really got to be waiting there for you.
Ooh,
now we're getting great advice from this corner, realizing that the guard was open on Carlos Garcia.
But he is in a Kimura trap now, so you have to be aware of that. If he had kept stepping through, behind the back, we're looking for a finish now. If it's straight, it's hard. You keep that 45-degree angle, it's very easy to break that arm. Reminiscent to ADCC, Ethan Krellison.
Almost
into the TVs again. Great work by the referee to separate them.
Carlos was very patient with that.
Yeah. 3 minutes and 20 seconds left into the match.
Carlos now looking to pass. Almost passed the legs. Tanner gets back in half guard. Carlos big on the heel. So many leg attacks. Oh, deep on that heel hook.
Yeah, it's hard to finish that.
He does not. When that leg is straight. A lot of the heel either. Yep.
Can't be ripping across. You got to really drive that elbow down towards the butt.
At least the bite is a lot better on that one.
Good defense there from Tanner.
Yeah. Oh, Carlos once again looking to pass, it seems. Just under 2 minutes left. In regulation. A possible back take by Carlos. Oh, back to attack on the leg. Once again, going in for the heel hook. From my angle, I'm not sure if he has it. Oh, possible straight angle.
We're in a little bit of a shootout here, folks. Hard to finish a straight when your back is on the mat. Now we're in a little bit better of an angle. And there as well. Tanner's starting to look for one of his own, I think. It's hard to tell from this angle.
Looks like he also has the boot on, so he's got a little bit of time.
Hope this kid comes to my leg lock seminar tomorrow.
He did not like giving up that leg. Speaking of which, use the JJT promotional website link to go buy Star-Lord's Quantum Breaking Mechanic DVD.
Don't hurt my soul when you can't finish leg locks.
Oh, boy. Once again, going up to the edge.
Tyler doing a good job slipping his heel. Carlos looking to reattack. And
ref calls for the reset.
Going to move him back to the center of the mat with 27 seconds left.
Yep.
All right, we got 18 seconds left in the match.
Someone's going to pull off a very quick submission in less than 10 seconds.
He's just leaving his inside heel just sitting there while he attacks a straight ankle lock. It's a dangerous move, Cotton. Let's see how it plays for him.
Time! It's Cotton?
That's what I said, Cotton.
Oh, that's a Kyle. My hearing is not great.
I mean, you kind of look like a Kyle.
Oh, that's...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that one hurt. We're going overtime. 3 minutes. This will be scored on the left-hand side. Carlos Garcia, right-hand side. Tanner Flesher. Let's go ahead and get started.
hype man, Jordan Peitzman. Nice snap down into the front headlock by Tanner.
Oh,
man.
Does he have hooks in?
I don't know about you, but Carlos looks like he's getting a little tired. Waiting to see that two for the takedown from the referee.
So close to getting both of those hooks in, too. But it looks like he's moving to mount. Just got to take care of that one leg.
No, he should have, though.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, Kyle, but I think those 2 points.
I despise you so much right now, but I actually agree, yes.
It's okay. So now we're on top with Tanner, top half, shoulder pressure. Walking his legs up.
He's looking to collect that arm, possibly for a head and arm choke.
Oh, I love this. All right, back into close guard.
Carlos retains his guard. Gains his guard.
Harder music for the main card, yes.
Yeah. Although the soft jazz is kind of doing it for me.
Yeah. Got a minute 22 left in this fight. Match, I'm sorry, it's not a fight. I hate it when that happens. Tanner looking for a possible outside heel hook, maybe a straight toe hold. I don't know. He's trying to get on that foot. There's the outside heel hook attempt. Very shallow right now. Carlos doing a good job hiding his heel and starting to stack now. Looks like he's going to spin through for a knee bar here.
It would be interesting to see.
That would have been a nice transition.
Oh, he's going for the back again. Carlos defending very well.
Jordan on the comment section with the fire. Oh, looking for an Estima lock attempt.
Just a massive amount of leg attacks we've seen. And the event is only just getting started here at BJJ Woodstock.
Time!
So what happens in a 0-0, Jordan?
Jordan.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, now we are moving into a sudden death overtime. The first point scored will win this match. Let's give it up for Carlos Garcia and Tanner Fletcher. Ready?
There you have it.
All right. We're going into golden score, folks.
We are going to see some blast takedowns from both of these men.
Let's hope they can keep it on the mats.
Oh, boy. Definitely getting close to the edge. Make me nervous.
Honestly, this sounds horrible. I'd rather them go off the edge than end at the TV screen. Nice takedown. Uh-huh. That should be two for Tanner.
Are they not going to call that?
This referee doesn't seem to like takedowns.
All right. Oh.
That should also be two.
Landing in top position.
Two!
All right, we got two up on the board. And that is a victory for Tanner Fletcher.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, your winner in sudden death overtime, Tanner Fletcher!
I love this.
Oh, boy.
It's going to be one of those nights. Yeah.
I mean, shout out to the amazing crew keeping this operation afloat from dawn to dusk. They've been just absolutely killing it. Is that
cool? Yeah, they had a long day today. They had the open tournament this morning. Now we're into the pro event. So, how does it feel being on site for Jiu-Jitsu Times, Kevin?
Well, I feel really lucky. I've gotten to see and meet a lot of really cool people because of writing in the jiu-jitsu space. And, yeah, it's just nice it's nice getting out, you know, especially seeing something like this happen during such a time of unrest. You know, something a lot of people might be missing is some entertainment. So hopefully you and I can help get that to them tonight, along with these amazing athletes. Just a lot of you seem to be tuning in. Thank you so much. If we could keep the comment section respectful, though.
Fuck that. Bring the hate, Kevin. This is how we know you're a noob when it comes to, you know, being a public figure.
Oh, boy.
It's tough for these small-minded folk in Iowa to understand the greatness that is sitting here on commentary. That is
good state.
Kevin Bradley and Josh.
I will say,
I don't know what's happening here.
Ladies and gentlemen, shout out to my brother, Josh Peitzman, competing today. Now he's helping us out with the music. So, give it up for my brother.
Phenomenal work from the other Peitzman.
Family affair.
Both of them so talented. For coming out.
Yeah, there we go. A little harder than that smooth jazz we've been playing.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, next up is a purple belt feature match at 185 pounds. First up, representing Seraphim BJJ, Chris Wojcik.
Chris Wojcik.
Oh, man.
And next up, representing Enzo Gracie Des Moines, Derek Flagg.
All right, and we are underway.
Oh, my God, I love this. The fake Hywel Teague.
Hey, he could be real.
No.
We don't know.
And here we go, folks.
That is the real Hywel Teague. Come on, Kevin. Learn about trolls. Derek, I've been watching for a minute here now. He's been on a lot of the subspectrums. I think he was down in Jacksonville for one of the tournaments as well. Yeah, that's what it was. He winked at me in a match. I mean, I'm not going to say that I found it oddly attractive, but I did.
There's a lot of now suddenly sexual tension here at the announce table. Oh.
Derek pulling guard there.
Oh.
All right. Into the leg entanglements here. Ooh, inside heel hook attempt now by Chris. Yeah. That could have done some damage. Derek is looking to hide his knee line now. Yeah.
Getting another bite on the leg.
Derek is that's cool. You want to see a leg lock? I'll show you one too.
Just a lot of leg locks tonight.
They're doing a decent job separating the feet. Chris is doing a good job hiding his heel in these entanglements. Derek again digging for the inside heel hook, looking to separate the feet. Looking for the outside now. Doing a good job keeping his feet hidden now after that deep inside heel hook attempt that he just weathered.
Oh, going deep on the leg.
Chris decides to disengage and start playing some top position.
Now, Josh, in rolling, do you initiate 50-50 more than people that try to put you in it?
Honestly, I don't really play leg locks.
Oh, really? That's crazy. I can't imagine why I think that. Oh, coming right up to the edge once again.
No, I mean, 50-50 is exactly that. If you don't have a deeper understanding than your opponent, you are leaving yourself open to some counterattacks. 80-20 is obviously a little more preferred.
Oh,
now,
Chris going for the back.
Gets on the back of Derek, looking to use this modified body triangle, walking his hand across the face. I like to say everything below the eyes is the neck. I've seen Wagner just break people's noses from the back.
Looks like he's trying to get the body triangle back, unable to do so.
Derek doing a good job defending right now. Chris starting to walk his hands, trying to get underneath that chin. Now he's across the jaw, locking in the full face crank here, hand behind the head. Let's see what kind of squeeze we're talking about here.
Well, reestablishes body lock on the other side.
Halfway through the match, 3 minutes left.
This is the first really prolonged back attack we've seen of the night. Oh, able to stay up.
And
rides
he moves
to mount.
The mount. Hops the shoulder.
Oh, possibly going to reset.
We're going to have someone
right
fall off.
The edge.
Now we're going to have Chris in full mount. Derek on the bottom.
He really fought hard to stay there. Oh, wow. Derek immediately able to get back to the feet. A lot of great crowd approval tonight. Oh.
Emil says,
I heard him.
Are you one of those
guys? Shout out to Emil Fisher, my coworker. Solid grappler. Hopefully, friend. I don't know if he likes me. I hope so.
Who cares what Emil thinks?
I like him. I like Emil.
There's two people I really dislike in the sport. That's Matt Kaplan and Emil Fisher.
Wow. So interesting you would put them together. Oh, wow. Chris going for the pass.
Minute 30 left in the match. Chris now starting to try to impede the hips of Derek, splitting the middle right to a knee cut. Derek trying to invert through to, you know, that John Thor back take or arm lock.
Transitioning from north-south back to side control. Maybe the neon belly.
Ooh, looking to set up a no-gi baseball bat choke, it looks like.
Youch.
Inverting through. That is the downside to neon belly in no-gis. They can really elevate you through and start looking to get on your legs.
Oh, Derek going
reattack right away. Again, a 50-50, trying to separate the heels. Chris is doing a good job separating. Derek hiding the heel well after that first attempt. Man, you can't just rip across on those outside heel hooks, man. They don't work like that. Starting to separate the feet again is Chris. Derek doing a good job now separating. With 34 seconds left in the match.
He looks like he's feeling something.
Someone's going to need to get a tight bite to finish this. Oh, hiding it again.
Shout out to the camera maestro for this entire event, Mouse, just making it happen.
Mouse is the man.
The man.
He doesn't trust these government names, though.
I mean, how can you? Oh, coming to the end here. Oh, one last deep straight ankle lock from Derek. Unable to get the finish.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are moving to overtime here between Derek Clegg and Chris Wojcik.
So great to look at this. All right, coming into overtime.
The only thing more lit than these matches is this comment section. I fucking love it. Ooh, good guillotine attempt by Derek.
Oh, wow, deep on that. Able to. Chris able to.
There's going
to
be two for Chris.
Takedown.
Derek taking a look at the scoreboard menacingly, trying to figure out what he's got to do here. Nice step over by Chris.
Derek good about opening and closing his guard when he feels he needs to.
Hopping over, looking for those flyover passes again. Derek trying to elevate, get something going.
Oh, and Chris disengages, back to the feet.
Nice.
Really solid top pressure from Chris.
Yeah, now he's going to start looking to take the back. One hook in. Looking to get that seatbelt tight. Might bypass and go straight on the neck here.
Oh, might trying to kick his leg in, but Derek defending very well with his left arm.
Give me your thoughts, man. No, look, Chris looks good. He's looking to get that left hook. He's maybe trying to trap the arm there before he gets the hook.
and it's there.
In the process, he's able to get both hooks. Looks like we're going to get three for Chris Wojcik to take a 5-0 lead.
All right, squeezing on the face now is Chris. Oh, man. Gotta really go for a long squeeze when you're doing these face crank jaw locks. You can't just squeeze for 3 seconds and let them go. That just lets their life suck back in.
Are Derek able to get to full guard? Oh, but Chris looking to trap that right arm. Getting riskier, going for triangles.
Nice. That was a good attempt there by Chris.
Yeah, he's not content with those five. He wants to cinch
this up. 15 seconds to go here, ladies and gentlemen.
It looks
like the crowd's like, thank God.
This will be enough to get him the win.
I thought that match was super entertaining. I don't know what's up with the crowd.
Time.
These do not feel like sub-only matches.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner in overtime, Chris Wojcik!
Say that again.
These don't feel like sub-only matches. They're going really fast. Aside from the...
Oh, you mean they're not dragged out and long?
Yeah. I mean, you can put it more succinctly than I did, but yeah, definitely.
I am quite succinct.
And how is the comment section going?
Oh, I love it. Man, the stream is going to be so lucky to see all of us up there on stage. I mean, they're so fucking lucky already to be hearing us. Yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and get things started with our next feature match here tonight. This is a purple belt match at 185 pounds. First up, representing Pentagon Submission Fighting, Alejandro Wagner.
All right, we got Alejandro coming out here, no shirt, from Pentagon. In Illinois.
All right, and next up, representing Academy of Combat Arts, fighting out of Fargo, North Dakota, Sydney Simons.
Sydney coming out in the purple rash guard.
And striking red and black undergarments, though.
The Pedigo crew has like a whole crew sitting there in the corner.
Oh, they are ready.
They squat up for this. All right. Alejandro just looks like a wrestler to me.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
Someone needs to take something else out of your mouth.
Here we go.
Oh, nice tuck under. Told you.
Amazingly.
Right to the
back.
Gorgeous. Nice duck under. Looking to get on the neck right away.
Getting that hook in. Or getting a hook in.
He's starting to send him up here. He's got
Sydney doing
first hook in, tight in on that neck,
oh,
man.
That
looks
that
pretty
looks
nasty, even with the arm in. Sydney does a good job, weathers the early storm to get on
wow.
top.
A lot of crowd approval on that one.
Some nasty cauliflower here on Alejandro.
Oh, wow, Sydney now looking to pass.
Oh, ooh, climbing to the back. And they're starting neutral.
Alejandro's definitely got a lot of explosiveness on him.
Ooh, nice shot by Sydney. Both these guys want to prove they can take each other down.
All
Nice duck under again by Alejandro.
Phenomenal. Right past.
Sydney says nice, and they both have a little laugh.
I mean,
it was nice.
You can't not love that.
Oh, yeah, it was gorgeous.
Looks like he's just happy to be a part of it. Oh, Sydney's definitely going to be fighting to get back. Alejandro controlling the head, looking for the guillotine. Oh, does he have it? No, he loses it, but transitions to a triangle attempt. Josh, how locked up does that look to you?
It's getting in there, man. When you're in these triangles, you want to try to really remove that shoulder and get all neck. You still want to obviously keep the arm in the triangle,
like,
but
he's
starting to adjust.
Mindful of the barrier. He mindfully doesn't want to potentially crash into it just to be reset. But that looks like that will be what happens anyway.
All right, so we got Sydney starting on top here. Staring deeply into his eyes from a full guard. Looking to start break open that closed guard. Traditional break, knee to tailbone, starting to press down. Guard opens. Looking to split the middle here.
Team Pedigo definitely showing up strong. A lot of support from their teammate.
Like I said, they squat up, man.
Alejandro proving he's just as effective off the back. Goes right to try to mount.
Nice. Passes turn, look for that head and arm choke.
The side control. Sydney definitely working that hook back in there. Trying to get back to half guard.
I like the pressure that Alejandro is starting to put on. Halfway through the match, 3 minutes left. Right to mount.
Trying to walk the hand up for a head and arm choke.
Yeah, back to that spider walk. Let's see if he can get his head to the mat, trap that arm.
Oh, able to maintain top control. A lot of good advice from his corner.
Ooh, right. Ooh. To the back there. Great work by Alejandro. Looking to go into the gear frat position. Oh,
that arm,
man. Locked in that body triangle.
Looks like they'll reset pretty soon. Yep, there he is. So, reset with Alejandro on the back of Sydney.
All right, he's got the cross grip, starts locking it in. That was nice. Right off the reset.
And
yeah,
there's the tap.
Right off the reset, we got Alejandro locking in the RNC.
Oh. Everyone's just happy with how cool that looks. Oh, phenomenal.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Alejandro
Wagner! Alejandro with the win.
Job, Alejandro.
Good work.
I love Flo.
And Alejandro just...
Pedigo loves Flo.
Starting some fire with my controversial co-host. I have no idea what he was talking about, but it sounded like he was angry.
No, he said he likes Flo.
Yeah, oh. Crazy. I don't know what that has to do with you.
Love it. I take back all the nice things I said about him.
Oh boy.
Nah, just kidding. That was awesome. Better. Yeah, you looked fucking good. Right, great wrestling, great duck unders.
Every hero story needs a duck under.
Yeah. I will happily play that
role. I don't know which role you are.
Well, obviously, if you knew anything about literature, there's something called the anti-hero. Obviously. All right, so we got Jake Bauer coming to the mat right now for the final prelim match before getting to the main card.
Just our second key match of the night here.
Second and final, I should say.
You know, I don't know if I would have yelled that on Subspectrum.
Representing Breaking Point Jiu-Jitsu by way of Davenport, Iowa, Victor Borja.
So Victor is in the black gi, and we got Jake in the blue gi.
With the blue hair to match.
I don't know if his hair is blue or if that's the light.
Possibly. That could just be me.
Yeah, it looks like the light, dude.
Ah, my mistake. Possibly bleach blonde, yes. But made blue by...
All right, so here we go. Last match in the prelims.
Jigging looks like slightly the larger grappler. Victor going in on the single. Jake going for the trip.
Why the logo on the left butt cheek, though?
All right, and Jake going to full guard.
All right, starting to look
Victor.
For the pass by Victor.
Just really sturdy looking. Trying to collect that other hand.
There it is. Nice. Ooh. Look for those leg drags right in.
Very smooth.
To a modified home base here, trying to win the insides.
Jake.
Jake doing a good job pummeling his feet back in, keeping him in the inside position here.
Victor just always looking for the pass.
Yeah, he's got very good pressure now.
Yep.
Nice. Oh, switching so sides as well. Ooh, oh, right to the flying armbar attempt. Victor's a savage, man.
Jake weathering that very well.
Jake does a good job of reverse the top position here, although we're still in the sub-only portion of the match. Victor playing that outside hook guard, doing a good job controlling the sleeves. Looks like he may start trying to move towards the back from here as well. Good collar and sleeve grip here.
Corner really wants him to get rid of that grip. Oh. 3 minutes to go here in regulation.
Again, in that outside hook guard. Jake doing a better job now, starting to drive into the hips so he can't really get that elevation going. Ooh, nice sweep attempt there by Vic.
Very, very happy being back at top.
Looking to save the TV screens.
Or their heads.
I'm more worried about those TV screens.
They are beautiful.
Yeah.
Tim will shoot those guys.
Yeah.
Oh,
I like Tim. He's going to let us play Smash on the TV after.
He legitimately has a silenced rifle in this building.
Oh, beautiful.
I don't know if anyone needs to know that. Or
there are church services here, though, so that's what he's prepared for.
All right.
Don't mess around.
Always prepared.
Jake. Very strong on top. We're going to take it back. Pulls him in. Oh, Jake, deep on the neck, looking to get that second hook in. Victor defending the other hook very well.
All right, moving to the back now is Jake. This is the best offense you've seen all match from him. Still minute 44 left in regulation. He's got that cross grip on the collar. Maybe he's going to start looking here for a bow and arrow choke.
He's playing around a lot with the hooks off the back, going for the body triangle. Honored to have. Honored to have.
It's all right. Alejandro is gonna be on Team Fuck Flow here in a second.
Honored to have a respected member of Flow Grappling watching this event, commenting. It's really cool.
That's why I love Blue Bells. They fucking believe anything you tell them.
I wish I could.
20 seconds on the match here. Jake still on the back. Looking for the arm lock now.
Wow. 10 seconds. Deep in on the arm. And he gets the tap with just 3 seconds remaining.
That was a great
regulation. Jake Bauer able to get the finish. That was.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, with the last second submission. Your winner by way of armbar with just 1 second remaining in the match. Jake Bauer!
The crowd erupts for Jake Bauer. You know, that's always tough for your opponent because it's like, man, could I have lasted one more second?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up our prelim card here tonight. We are going to take a short 5 to 10 minute break, and then we are going to come right back with one of the most stacked main cards we have ever seen in Subspectrum history. First up, we have Andrew Wiltsey taking on Pierre-Olivier Leclerc. And on the other side of the men's 185-pound bracket, we have Aaron Harris taking on William Tackett. I was about to say the same match again. So, that is our main event. In the co-main event, we have a rematch from Subspectrum 7, our men's 125-pound championship. We have Austin Davron taking on Nate Williams, the local. And also on our main card, we have Adam Bradley from Athos HQ taking on Nick Spacek from Apex House of Grappling in Chicago. So just a couple minutes here, folks. Go ahead, get some drinks, get some food, say hi to your family, buy a shirt, do whatever you got to do. Go say hi to our sponsors, support everything that we've been doing here today, and we will be back in just a couple minutes with our main card.
All right, guys, I'm going to let you guys take over. I have to go coach P.O. in the main event so you guys can do your little commentary here.
Jake. All right, we will strive to honor you in your absence. This will do. This will do. All right, this is absolutely phenomenal. Thank you very much, Josh. Phenomenal start to the event. Absolutely amazing preliminary matches. Finishes all around. It's an incredibly exciting overtime. Once again, I'm Kevin Bradley. No relation, no relation to competitor Adam Bradley. Bringing you sideline commentary for BJJ Woodstock via the honor of the Jiu-Jitsu Times news blog. And here we are with Kevin Jordan Peitzman. Jordan, how you doing, man?
Pretty good. How are you, man?
I am very, very thrilled to be here. It's the best seat in the house. I feel like things are going to get very controversial for me very soon.
Go for it.
There you go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we've got BJJ Woodstock. We're getting ready to head into our main card portion of the event. We have an incredible card here at the top of our lineup today. We have a 185-pound championship. It's going to be our main event. We have Aaron Harris taking on William Tackett in the first match of our main card here. And then we also have Andrew Wiltsey of Pedigo Submission Fighting taking on Pierre-Olivier Leclerc of TriStar Gym. So the winner of that is going to take home $1,250. I know that's an odd amount. But yeah, it's going to be an incredible bracket. We also have our men's 125-pound championship between Austin Daffron and Nate Williams coming up. It's a rematch from our men's 135-pound championship last year, and that's another match that I'm excited about. And we also have Mr. Adam Bradley taking on Nick Spacek. You guys know anything about any of these competitors on the card? Adam Bradley, you can go ahead and take it over. Or talk to you.
Okay, well, thank you, Jordan. Aside from a possible familial relationship with Adam, my last name being Bradley as well, a lot of these guys were unknowns before I started looking into the tournament. Wiltsey was the last edition. What about you?
Yeah, I mean, the format bracket is very stacked. Obviously, you got Will Tackett, who's a fucking killer. He's been on a streak recently, doing big things out of Texas. He's taking on Aaron Harris, the New York prodigy out of Black Hole Jiu-Jitsu. Kid's really good. And obviously, Pedigo Submission Fighting with Andrew Wiltsey is, yeah.
My biggest concern is that we are not far enough from the ledge here, personally, located on the commentary table. And I just know, given this lineup, we're going to see some pretty intense takeouts.
Oh, yeah.
I would just hope they would aim for somewhere within.
Let's hope they don't hit the screen. Let's hope they don't go off the mat, and let's just hope for some good fights, man. I'm really excited. The matchup between Tackett and Aaron Harris, I really think it's going to be a fight of the night, just because both of them have really explosive styles. They're super aggressive, and they're very submission heavy.
And also, Pierre, P.O., coming down to us by way of Canada, TriStar Gym. You spent a lot of time with them leading up to this tournament. How do you describe his mindset?
Yeah, I mean, P.O. is one of those guys that he's been on a lot of my shows. He's been around for a while. He's got a very light body, heavy style, really good arm bars as well. But he's just in here as a small guy, not really caring. He's going for broke, you know. He's trying to just take everyone out here, and he's a huge underdog in this bracket. So, I'm really excited about seeing him in there against Pedigo's Andrew Wiltsey.
Well, no matter what, everyone's stock is going to just skyrocket, given how explosive all of these matches have been, including the prelims.
Yes.
Non-stop submissions, leg attacks, and incredibly electrifying overtime.
Yeah.
Like, I couldn't be more pleased.
Yeah, the prelims have been insanely good. Hopefully, it carries over the main card, and like you said, their stock is going to skyrocket live and free on YouTube, so you know, this is going to be seen by everyone. There's no paywall. There's no pay-per-view. This is for the fans, and Subspectrum's doing a really good job putting out a lot of content that people can really consume easily.
Yeah, and shout out to all the people that have been working this entire event so far. It's been a stacked day with a lot of problems that have been put out, but everyone has been on top and on point the entire time. A lot of people walked away with their experiences and some of the tournaments that have gone on throughout the day, so it's just a lot of good energy leading into this tournament.
Yeah, it looks really good, and that energy is going to continue to go forward. Looks like we're going to get ready to get started here in a couple minutes, so anything you want to close with here, Kevin?
It's been fun, and thank you for being my co-host.
Yeah, man. I'm here to take you through these dangerous, treacherous waters, so I'm excited.
I don't know what I'm doing, folks. I'm sorry.
All right, here we go. Let's get into this main event.
Let's hear it. All right. Looking for that mermaid escape here is Aaron. Tackett's got very good pressure when he's in this position. He does that kind of crisscross feet mount.
So what kind of attacks do you think he's going to go for?
Oh. Nice entry on the leg. Good defense there by Tackett.
Great leg control. Maybe going for the guillotine. Oh, and they're going to be reset. Great ride time from Tackett.
Yeah. Too bad this isn't wrestling. Right away, Aaron sits guard. Tackett right away splitting the middle.
Oh, and getting back to the mat briefly, unable to stay.
Strong underhook here from Tackett. Looking to maybe set up a razor arm bar from the top. You can get past the legs of Aaron.
Aaron like pushing that left leg back.
Yeah, Aaron wedging his knee out.
And they're back. Back on the feet. Definitely going to see more of that. What kind of attacks do you think he's going to be trying once he gets back and once he's secured?
Dude, he's got a really good triangle. He's
yeah.
Trying to isolate the arm, so I wouldn't be surprised if
he had an arm.
Yeah, here comes the head and arm attack. I was going to say, either head and arms or kind of triangles.
He looks so strong here. He's really driving his head.